This session, we are going to learn about control flow statements in Unity C Sharp. What are control flow statements in Unity C Sharp? Control flow statements are the statements that alter or change or modify the flow of a program or a code. It provides better control on the flow of execution of a code. More complex programs can also be written using control flow statements. Now, the program is executed from top to bottom in the order it's written. Control flow statements can modify the flow of the execution of a program. So the code which is executed from top to bottom can be modified using control flow statements. Thank you for the session. I will see you in the next session. Thank you so much. Control flow statements in Unity C Sharp. Now, what are the types of control flow statements? The first is your decision making statements. Then we have switch statements, and then we have looping statements. What are decision making statements? Decision making statements is similar to that of making decisions in your real life. It will execute certain block of code if the condition is true or is satisfied. The if statement checks for the condition. If the condition is true, then the block of code is executed. Otherwise, it is not executed. Let's get into the Unity editor and let's write a piece of code for an if statement. Guys, we have already declared a variable player health here, which is of data type int, and the value is set to 30. Inside the start function, there is an if condition, and we are checking whether player health is lesser than 50 or not. And if the player health is lesser than 50, then we are going to print in the console player's health is too low. So we have our output here inside the Unity console. Thank you for the session. I will see you in the next session. Thank you so much. We are going to learn about control flow statements in Unity C Sharp. If statements checks for the condition, and if the condition is true, then the block of code inside the if statement is executed. But what if the condition is false? In that case, the code inside the else statement will be executed. The else statement tells the code what to do if the condition is false. Again, we have declared a variable of data type int, which is player health, and the value is set to 70. Inside the start function, we are checking if the player health, the value of player health is lesser than 50 or not. If the condition is true, then we are going to print player's health is too low inside the Unity console. And if the condition here is false, then player's health is good will be printed inside the Unity console. So guys, here it is. Here is the output. Player's health is good. Thank you for the session. I will see you in the next session. Thank you so much. Hi friends, my name is Rohan Vasudev, and in this session, we are going to learn about control flow statements in Unity C Sharp. If else if ladder statement checks for each if condition. All the statements are checked from top to bottom. First condition will be checked first, then the second condition will be checked, then it moves on to the third, and so on and so forth. The code inside the if statement is executed, which evaluates to be true. Only the code or the block of code inside the if else statement will be executed, which will be true. If none of the if conditions are true, then the last else block will be executed here. Now, the player health is set to the value of 50. Inside the start function, we have an if condition. Inside the if condition, we are checking whether player's health is greater than or equal to 80 and player health is smaller than or lesser than or equal to 100. And if the condition is true, then we are going to print player's health is super. If the condition is false here, then it moves on to the else if statement here. Now, again, it checks for player health greater than or equal to 60 and player health smaller than or equal to 70. Now, if the condition is true here, then this block of code will be executed. Otherwise, if it is false, then it moves on to the next statement, which is player health greater than equal to 40 and player health lesser than equal to 59. Again, if the condition is true here, then the block of code will be executed and player's health is not good will be printed in the Unity console. If the condition is false here, then it moves on to the else statement, and finally, if all the conditions are false here, then lastly, code inside the else statement, player's health is in a bad state, will be printed in the Unity console. Now let's run the code and see the output in the Unity console. Player's health is not good. So here it is, here is the output. Thank you for the session. I will see you in the next session. Thank you so much. We spoke about decision making statements. In this session, we are going to talk about switch statements. What are switch statements? Switch statements are an alternative for if else if ladder statement. Switch case statement is a selection statement. Here is the syntax for a switch case statement, wherein we have a switch keyword and then we have to put the expression inside the bracket and then we have cases inside it. Now the block of code or statement is executed if the expression matches with one of the case or expression value. Again, we have a break keyword here. Now this break statement is used to move out of the switch once the expression matches with one of the cases. So once the value for the expression matches with the value for the case, then the break statement is used and the switch is ended. The switch will continue to check for all the cases until the break statement is found or the switch ends. Now lastly, if none of the case matches with the expression, then the last default case is executed and the block of code inside the default case is printed or executed. And again, the switch is ended using the break statement in the default case. Now let's get into the Unity editor and let's write a piece of code. Now guys, we are here into Unity editor. We have created an empty game object. We have also created a C# script and the name of the script is switch case. Let's open the switch case script and let's have a look at the code. Inside the script, we have already declared a variable player's health and the value is set to 20. Inside the start function, we have already declared switch case statements and player's health here is an expression. Case 10 will check if the value of player's health is equal to 10 or not. If the value of player's health is equal to 10, then the block of code, which is case 10, is executed, will be printed in the Unity console. And the break statement will end the switch. If the value does not matches with the expression, then it will move on to the case 20. Case 20 will check if the value of player's health is equal to 20 or not. If the value of player's health is equal to 20, then the block of code, which is case 20, is executed, will be printed in the Unity console and the break statement will end the switch. If the value of player's health is not equal to 20, then it will move on to the default case and the default case is executed, will be printed in the Unity console. Lastly, the break statement will end the switch here. Here is the output, case 20 is executed. Thank you so much for the session. I will see you in the next session. Thank you so much, guys. We are going to learn about loop control statements. So what are loop control statements? Loop control statements are used when you want a statement or a block of code to be executed multiple times, again depending on the conditions to be evaluated. The condition to be evaluated needs to be true for the executions of the statements or block of code inside the loop. So the condition has to be true if you want these statements inside the loops to be executed multiple times. What are the types of loops we have here? We have while loop, for loop, and do while loop. Let's have a look at a while loop. What is a while loop? The condition is applied at the beginning of the loop. Loop variable initialization is done before and outside the loop. So the variable which you're going to initialize, it's going to be outside the loop and not inside the loop. Now the block of code inside the loop will be executed till the condition is true. And once the condition becomes false, then the loop will be exited or terminated. Here is the syntax for a while loop. First is your loop variable initialization. This is where you initialize the variable which is outside the while loop. Then we have a while loop, and then we have a condition inside the brackets for a while loop. Now inside the while loop, we have a block of code to be executed. And once the block of code is executed, we do increment or decrement of a loop variable. So guys, inside the script, we have already declared a variable health of data type int, and the value is set to 5. Inside the start function, we have also declared a while loop in which we have a condition where we are checking whether value of health is greater than 0. Inside the while loop, we are printing the value of health, and once the value of health is printed, we are decrementing the value of health by 1. Once the value of health is 0, the loop will be exited or terminated. Let's run the script and let's see the output here. Okay, so here is the output. Player health is 5, player's health is 4, player's health is 3, player's health is 2, and player's health is 1. For loop is similar to that of while loop with a different syntax. Initialization of a loop variable, testing of a condition, increment and decrement of a loop variable are in one single line here. The block of code inside the loop will be executed again till the condition is true, and once the condition becomes false, then the loop will be exited. Inside the start function, we have a for loop declared. Inside the brackets for the for loop, we have already initialized a variable I whose value is set to 1. Then we have a condition in which we are checking whether value of I is smaller than 5. Then again, the value of I is being incremented by 1 on every iteration. Inside the loop, we are executing a statement. In this case, we are just printing the value of I in the Unity console using debug.log function. Let's run the code and let's see the output here. Player score is 1, player score is 2, player score is 3, and player score is 4. Do while loop is similar to while loop, except that it checks the condition only after the statements are executed. Executes the statements at least once before it checks for the condition. Now inside the script, we have already declared a variable coins whose value is set to 1. Inside the start function, we have declared a do while loop. Inside the do block, we are printing the value for the coins. Once the value of coins is printed in the Unity console, the value of coins is incremented by 1. The do while loop will check for the condition here whether the value of coins is lesser than 0. If the condition is true, it will again get into the do block and the block of code will be executed. If the condition is false, the loop here will be exited or terminated. So let's run the code and let's have a look at the output in the Unity console for this. So here is the output, guys. Number of coins 1. Since the condition was false, the loop is exited here. So that's it, guys. I will see you in the next session. Thank you so much, guys.